George.
Hello, Lowe. A boy that's been with us for 7 years. He was just appointed in the Ludlow Police Department to replace a man that's been 23 years with us, Sergeant Bruno Focosi, who will be retiring the 31st of December.
John George, the police chief in Ludlow. The town treasurer in Wilbraham is pushing hard to name an assistant, but selectmen have equally strong opinions on delaying such a move. With the latest on that from last night's board meeting in Wilbraham
town treasurer,
that those states wanting
to consider his selection of Nancy Treby as assistant treasurer because the one selected by selectmen did not want the job. The board asked Treasurer Bergen Saddam to hold off making his appointment request. Selectman John Lovejoy said the board was looking at alternative ways to fill the post. Selectman Frank Horsek, noting one of Selectman Lovejoy's arguments, said that after an election, a new treasurer might select another person as his assistant, pointing out the importance of satisfying needs of the treasurer for a part-time person. Treasurer Saddam called account reconciliation a monstrous task, adding that a knowledgeable person is needed immediately because the secretary is leaving in January and his assistant wants to go back to that type work, and a new person should experience a couple of payrolls with guidance. Selectman Lovejoy said he has trouble with the treasurer's choice because her husband, the school business manager, makes $40,000.
There was a similar operation in Spencer within the past few years, which officials were not too happy with, but by this time it's believed they found the right people to run an arcade. With that story from Spencer, Carol Plum.
At a public hearing held this week, the Spencer Zoning Board of Appeals granted a special permit to Gary Keyes of Spencer to operate a family amusement center at 174 Main Street. A variance is required by a local ZBA in order to conduct an arcade. Keyes plans to start with 10 machines and add more if the need demands. Keyes promised that there would be adult supervision in the arcade at all times. Hours of operation will be Sunday through Thursday from noon to 9:30 and Friday and Saturday from noon to 10:30. Keyes also told the ZBA that children under 16 will not be allowed into the arcade during school hours unless they are accompanied by an adult.
A former town official in Ware has some recollections of the late Reverend Valentine Kustosh of St. Mary's Church, who died suddenly yesterday. We'll get to that story in just a moment. Adway is your bird food headquarters. Save on feathered friend bird food mixture. The 50-pound bag, regularly $11.49, now just $9.99. The 50-pound bag of sunflower seed, sale price just $12.49. Palmer Adway, where you'll also save on cracked corn, peanut heart, thistle seed, sunflower chips, red and white millet, red wheat, suet cakes, and more. Plus, remember that Adway is your complete bird care center, carrying a complete line of bird feeders. Adway, 445 Park Street in Palmer.
Adway answers your needs.
Halen, to heal or make well again. Now Dr. Cantasilia of the Halen Medical Center is available at Mary Lane Hospital in Ware. The Halen Medical Center is the finest ear, nose, and throat and facial cosmetic surgery facility in central Massachusetts, with the finest doctors, nurses, and equipment available. Located in the Pleasant Medical Complex in Worcester and the Medical Arts Building in Southbridge, now they have a clinic in Ware on a regular basis at Mary Lane Hospital. So if you have any ear, nose, or throat problems, any questions about cosmetic surgery, see Dr. Cantasilia of the Halen Medical Center at Mary Lane Hospital in Ware. Call the Worcester office for an appointment at 791-6305 or inquire at Mary Lane Hospital.
The loss will be felt for some time at St. Mary's Church in Ware. 72-year-old Reverend Valentine Kustosh is gone. But there are so many memories that will linger. One of the parishioners who knew Father Kustosh very well is the former town clerk in Ware, Peter Resnikevitz. He agreed that the pastor's toughness was just a veneer.
As to the ordinary person approaching, but I suppose he got this over the years, that he had a heart of gold, and he was for children 100%. But I suppose he, you know, people always appeared tough. And he figured if I was tough, not to be tough really, but to act tough, that I would forget more. And he used, whether he used it or just did it because it was his nature, but if you knew the man, down deep in his heart, he had a heart of gold and it's soft, and he would use it to the best advantage. And I have yet to know of any person that ever was turned away that was asking for something in conjunction with the religion and the church that he was serving.
The greatest pride Father Kustosh had was St. Mary's School. With his death, what about the future of the school?
It's going to be rough. Because, first of all, we were able to, Father Kustosh's good connections with the sisters, that he was able to get a number of sisters, and so their pay wasn't nowhere near compared to the ordinary lay teacher. And so that is going to be a big problem. We haven't got that number of parishioners, and the cost to run a school with lay people is tremendous.
Peter Resnick-Cabot, Ware, former town clerk. Ware, selectmen have also taken action in memory of Father Kustosh.
Selectman Stanison, you are chairman of the board. At this time, it is with a saddened heart we will fly the flag at half-mast at the town hall till after the funeral for Father Valentine Kustosh.
Arrangements are still being made at this hour as to who will offer the concelebrated Mass of the Resurrection for Father Kustosh. The Mass is scheduled for 11 a.m. Saturday morning at St. Mary's Church. Visiting hours also at the church will be from 1 p.m. to 7 p.m. Christmas Day. Arrangements are being handled by the Sebula Funeral Home, and the burial will take place at St. Mary's Cemetery. Reverend Valentine Kustosh, dead at age 72. He was at St. Mary's Church. More news in a moment.
Hello, this is Iris Block. That's spelled I-R-S, last name Block. Here with just some of the 17 reasons why you should let Medeiros Williams Chevrolet in Wilbraham figure your next car purchase. Reason number 7. Medeiros Williams Chevrolet does not charge extra when the car you buy has water in the battery. Reason number 9. Air in the tires is free, including air in the spare. And Medeiros Williams will figure in the cost of your new car without figuring in the cost of the keys. And reason number 15, Medeiros Williams won't charge you for the car's rear sticker that shows you bought the car from Medeiros Williams, which shows you have good taste. This is Iris Block, spelled IRS, last name Block, saying stay tuned for more of the 17 reasons why you should let Medeiros Williams figure your next car purchase.
That's Medeiros Williams Chevrolet, with all the latest 1982 model cars. And for a real bargain, select a new 1981 at great savings, full warranty in effect. Medeiros Williams Chevrolet in Wilbraham.
There were just two bidders for insurance coverage in Holland this week, and selectmen decided not to stay with the local agency that has served the town for a long period of time. Penny Lawrence reports on that.
After having provided insurance coverage for the town of Holland for years, a Sturbridge insurance company lost out to an underbidding company of Boston. Selectmen in Holland signed a new $26,000 plus insurance policy with the firm of Taylor Kearney, Leifer & Company of Boston. Formerly, the town has been insured by the Ropiac Insurance Company of Sturbridge. The two companies were the only bidders for the insurance coverage, which will cover all town employees, including teachers, police, and public officials, as well as town vehicles and workmen's compensation.
Warrenstown's fathers have extended a show of good faith and a helping hand to a resident in need. Plus, they're looking for someone to fill a town position on a temporary basis, with details on both of those topics. Concerning Warren, Barry Krieger.
One of the first orders of business of the Warren Board of Selectmen last night was a vote of support from the board to Richard Grabowski, whose house burned down yesterday. Selectman Edward Fleming said that two other organizations in the town have come forward to offer help. The elementary school and the Warren branch of Stop IT have both volunteered to take in food, clothing, toys, and money to help the burned-out family. Selectman Donald Nickerson noted that David Hitchcock, who has been on two-month leave of absence from his positions as highway superintendent and highway surveyor, will be in town today to tender his resignation, effective immediately. Anyone in Warren interested in filling the position of temporary highway superintendent until next spring should submit his or her name to the Board of Selectmen by next Tuesday.
The news continues on WARE after this message. Without Wayne Cashman for four games. He was suspended by the league for his stick-throwing incident with the L.A. game Sunday night. High school basketball, Prouty beat South 61-55, Quabbin over Lunenburg 61-60. Even though there was no school at Tantaskwa today, there will be the basketball game tonight, where at Tantaskwa that game will be played at its regular time. Let's look at sports. Now, J.P. has the Radio 125 forecast.
And it goes like this. Scattered showers this afternoon. Highs in the 35 to 40 degree range. Partial clearing tonight, lows in the 20s. Partly cloudy, the outlook for tomorrow. Highs 35 to 40. The forecast for Christmas Day, partly cloudy. High temperature readings in the 30s. This is 35 degrees currently. For Carl Bean, I'm J.P. Ellery. Jackie Murphy has sound off right now.
WARE now presents the area's foremost talk show. Now in its 19th year.
Sound off with Jackie Murphy.